finding a comfortable position. Just readjusting if there are any areas of tension or tightness, just getting comfortable. And when you find that comfortable position, just allowing your eyes to close, making sure you're not sitting back in a bucket seat or hunched back in a couch. You're either lying on your side or sitting up straight, giving your baby plenty of room to move around. Good. And just noticing how comfortable it is to allow your eyes to close, to give yourself the gift of calm, of comfort, of rest. Allowing yourself to just rest in this moment, taking in long, slow, easy breaths in and out through your nose, in and out through your nose, allowing each breath to take you deeper and deeper into relaxation. Good. I'm now going to count down from 20 to 0. And as I do, you're going to feel a euphoric expansion spread from the top of your head to the tips of your toes. This expansion is going to begin the process of giving your baby plenty of space to turn into the ideal position for birth. Their head is the heaviest part of their body, and gravity will support them in turning if there is enough room for that turn. So that will be our intention for this meditation, creating space for a turn, energetically connecting with your baby and encouraging them to make that turn, to summon the power of gravity to support this process. Beginning to count down now, feeling your body, specifically your uterus and abdomen, comfortably softening and expanding as I count down. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, expanding, softening more and more. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, releasing and relaxing every nerve, cell, muscle in your body. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, expanding and softening more and more. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Deep in the core of your subconscious mind now, a space where you can connect with your baby and foster the process of them turning in to the ideal position for birth. Just envisioning yourself floating in a golden mist in the core of your subconscious mind. A golden mist that supports you in the process of connecting and communicating with your baby. Taking a few quiet moments to enjoy the sensation of floating in this mist. you to envision a golden cord going from your mind into your baby's mind. A cord that allows you to transmit messages to them and receive messages from them. Now that you've envisioned that cord, I'm going to give you a series of messages that I want you to send to your baby. It is safe to turn. Allow gravity to pull your head towards my cervix. My body will continue to soften more and more, giving you the space to turn. Trust your instinct to allow your head to move down, down, down. As my body creates more and more space, you turn down more and more. We are working together to create the ideal circumstances for birth. You turn more and more with every deep breath I take. We can do this together. Once again, it is safe to turn, little baby. Allow gravity to pull your head towards my cervix. My body will continue to soften more and more, giving you the space to turn. Trust the instinct to allow your head to move down, down, down. As my body creates more and more space, you turn more and more. We are working together to create the ideal circumstances for birth. You turn more and more with every breath I take. We can do this together. Taking a few quiet moments to send any other messages to your baby, and opening your mind to any messages they might want to send to you. Very good. I'm now going to take you on a journey through various turning techniques. As I describe the following techniques, you can actually pause the recording and get into the position, or you can just envision yourself getting into them, setting the intention that you'll practice after the meditation is complete. We'll first explore the child's pose, which encourages your baby's feet or their butt to lift out of your pelvis and flip to the upper portion of your uterus. to do, you'll get on all fours on a soft surface. Then lay your head down with your butt sticking up into the air. We're really focusing on getting your butt up into the air. Giving you a moment, if you would like to actually get into the position to do that. Getting into the child's pose by first getting on all fours on a soft surface, laying your head down, having your butt sticking up into the air as much as is comfortable. And if you become lightheaded or uncomfortable, you can just ease out of the position and lay on your side. But if you are comfortable in this position, just stay there for a moment, as we're going to take a few quiet breaths. We're going to rest here, energetically urging baby to lift out of the pelvis and begin the process of turning head down. And as you rest, take long, deep breaths, envisioning and feeling yourself softening and expanding more and more, sending baby the message to turn. Good. Now we're going to do what I like to call on all fours belly dancing. And this gives baby gentle encouragement to make the turn. So to do, you're going to get on your hands and knees on a soft surface and begin gyrating your hips like you were belly dancing. You can even swirl your hips to the music. Again, getting on your hands and knees on a soft surface and just gyrating your hips like you were belly dancing. Taking a few quiet moments to continue this position and movement, gently encouraging baby to turn. Good. And now we're going to envision something called the pelvic tilt. But because this one requires the support of a companion, I ask that you hold off on actually getting into this position until you have that support. But if you have that support nearby, you can pause and ask them to come and help you with this position. But if you're just envisioning it, envision yourself getting back on that soft surface and lying on your back with your knees bent and feet planted on the floor. You'll then lift your hips into the air. This is the bridge pose used in yoga. But we're going to make it easier by having a friend or family member stack pillows under your hips until you're able to rest in this position. Taking a few quiet moments to envision yourself in that position and feeling it providing further motivation for your baby to pull out of the pelvis so they will have room to turn, more flexibility to turn head down. I now want you to journey with me through the additional techniques you can use to support your baby in turning. If you choose to engage in any of these, I encourage you to listen to this meditation as you receive the treatment to help enhance the effectiveness. So first, we're going to explore moxibustion. This technique is derived from Chinese medicine, and it consists of a licensed acupuncturist burning mugwort close to your pinky toes. The idea is that the stimulation of heat by these points encourages the release of estrogen and prostaglandins, which stimulate mild contractions that encourage the baby to turn without causing preterm labor. So I want you to envision that now. Envision an acupuncturist burning mugwort by your pinky toes. I want you to also start feeling a bit of heat in your pinky toes and sensing that the heat in this area is causing the release of estrogen and prostaglandins and stimulating mild contractions that encourage the baby to turn. Taking a few quiet moments to envision that. Very good. In addition to the moxibustion, you can now envision an acupuncturist placing the tiny needles on parts of the body that promote relaxation in your uterus and create an overall sense of calm. So taking a few moments to really feel that, the relaxation pulsating through your uterus and the overall sense of calm washing over your body. And now I want you to envision yourself receiving a successful ECV, or external cephalic version. This is a technique that might be recommended by your care provider if the baby doesn't turn with gentler techniques by week 36 or 37 of gestation. But because this technique can be a bit uncomfortable, we're going to envision that you're floating above yourself as you calmly lie in a hospital bed, feeling ready to receive an ECV. So you watch as the trained care provider comes into the room and they press on specific areas of your abdomen to encourage the baby to turn. And that is all that an ECV is. A trained care provider pressing on specific areas of your abdomen to encourage the baby to turn. And so as you watch yourself in the scene, you see that you're incredibly relaxed and taking deep, slow breaths, enhancing the efficacy of the procedure. And then you see the care provider smile and say that the technique worked. Very good. Now I want you to envision yourself just floating back into that soft golden mist in the core of your subconscious mind. That mist that infuses you with a euphoric sense of calm. I also want you to re-envision that golden core that goes from your mind to your baby's mind, taking some time to gently float in this calm space and connect with your baby. Good. Now, before we end this meditation, I would like you to take yourself to the day of your baby's birth and envision them gently coming out of your body, head down, watching that scene from above, marveling at the power and serenity coursing through your body. You can watch as your baby gently comes out of your body and is placed in your arms, The two of you are in perfect health, overflowing with love and connection. Taking a few moments to really enjoy that scene, watching your baby come out, head down, perfectly healthy, you're perfectly healthy, and then the two of you connect and bond and overflow with the most euphoric sense of love you have ever known. Now, if you are in a place where you can continue to rest, I encourage you to do so, lying on your side or another comfortable position, just really feeling and envisioning your uterus, your abdomen softening and expanding, giving your baby plenty of room to turn, and all the while sending your baby the message through that golden core that it is time to turn into the head down position, that it is safe to turn. So again, if you can, just resting and ignore the following messages. If you are in a place where you need to come back up and resume your day, follow along as I count up from 1 to 5. 1, taking in a deep, invigorating breath. 2, wiggling your fingers and your toes. 3, feeling wonderful in every way. 4, committing to listening to this meditation as often as possible and practicing the turning techniques as often as you can. And 5, whenever you are ready, eyes open, wide awake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Eyes open, wide awake.